tu dois chi avenir.
Just make sure you come tomorrow. Okay, let's take a look at the software side. So I think you have already done this. This is presented in the tutorial too. Okay, where you draw the graphs, you draw the charts. You have done the chart already in the tutorial one, right? You draw the ratio of the density versus the modulus. So now they are ready to get the development classification, so you can actually draw a material bar chart. Yeah, all the log scale. You can see the way it's level one. You can actually see how they look like the result ranking. So I did show you the ranking lessons. And this is the modulus versus the density bubble chart. Yeah, also the log scale. And the circle refers to family. Family occupies in the region. So this red color is belong to the metal, and within this bubble chart metal there is more things than the metal itself. And we can see the bubble chart created. Alright, can see different areas, then that's where the shade comes in, the shaded areas. So you're creating this chart for your CSVs. And the chart is only like that. It doesn't give you much information because you need to include the constraint, the parameters that governs the condition for your applications. And you've got to draw the line. Constraint, where the line is a ratio between the modulus and the density. The line is derived from the material indices. The line is, you derive the line when you are solving an equation. So that means if I give you a shape, I give you a beam, I give you a T-shape, I give you a cylinder, I give you a tube, I give you a sphere, with two spheres embedded inside. You're supposed to derive the material indices based on the object's dimension, based on the constraint, based on the material properties, based on the client requirement. You're supposed to come up with the material indices that try to find the optimum materials used for that particular application. The line is the material in this line. And from there, you can select. Should be able to help you select and rank the materials according to the best one. And you have to learn how to shift the line. The shifting of line has a significant meaning. If you shift upwards, what does it mean? If you shift downward, what does it mean? Are you trying to reduce the cost? Or are you trying to reduce the size? Or reducing the density? The shifting of the line shows you things. Next, can you see the different lines there? There are many lines there. These lines are what you call the material index lines. It's very specific for a particular application, right? For a particular constraint. When I say constraint, I'm referring to what's our ratio. Are you looking at modulus over density? Are you looking at modulus over the weight? Are you looking at modulus over the cost? Look at the thermal properties. You can also have thermal properties as well. Different lines appear in the graphs, different ratios. So it tells you what condition you're looking at. Okay? So when you look at the chart management, these are the options available in the chart. You just just have to press the top option, the line selection tool, and the box selection tool. You can select the material based on box, you can select the materials based on line. And the one that I talked to you is using the line selection tool. The line selection tool is the one that you see the bottom line, all the lines coming up. That is under the line selection tool, and the line selection tool, the gradient of the line will change accordingly. And the gradient of the line will be found when you are deriving your material. So meaning means that there is no error carry forward. First one wrong, the whole entire question wrong. I warn you. A 20 mark question, your first derivation is wrong, right behind all wrong. So that's why you must be particularly very careful. And I think the next few lessons, you learn how to derive the material equations.
This one, each line is based on that material at the area or the
this
whole?
This line is based on the equation that you are deriving. Based on the object, it could be a sphere, it could be a cylinder, it could be a beam due to deflection. Then from the beam of deflection, you are supposed to derive the basic constraint. For example, you're looking at modulus, you're looking at the density. Then you want to minimize the mass or maximize the strength. It means you want to have the maximum strength. What should be my governing equation? And the governing equation will be derived from those lines there. Those lines is your selection line. You can shift the line up and down. Later you will understand what I'll be talking about later. The line can be shifted up and down because the line is the governing relationship between the factors, between the constraint that you're looking at. For example, I want to have maximum strength. Where will my graph shift to? In the graph you know that in terms of strength, you look at the modulus. But if I shift upwards, I got a problem because I have another constraint, which is my density. If I shift upward too high, my density will be compromised. So you've got to worry about this. And the gradient will shift. Right now, in this case, you look at the graph, I mean, apparently it seems that the density and the Young modulus is related, 1:1 ratio. Not 1:1, there's a constant in front of the equation. Why would mx plus c, right? The gradient is about a constant over the x-axis. So there's a constant. That constant will change accordingly to equations. So that is the slide. You'll be using the line selection tool most of the time, the box selection tool, right? Add tabs and blah and zoom, whatever all this possible. So you can select materials, you can use the box selection tool, low stiffness, and the one with the high conductivity, low expansion. So these are how you can select the materials. So how do you create chart? We have done it already in tutorial 1. Press select, choose the template, graph, and then you choose the property looking at, and then you choose the property 1. You choose the y-axis, x-axis. And you also have learned the option under question 1. You also learned how to have ratio, remember? You calculated the ratio modulus over somewhere. Modulus of shear over modulus, and the modulus over density. You can have an equation. It means you can divide or you can multiply the quantity. And I did show. Did I show you the limit? Yes. I also did show you the limit. When I press the limit, that's where I put in the constraint. Okay? So? And I also see a done that also right, tutorial 2, the one right, you get the chain axis, you press advance, you can actually do in debug, modulus over the densities. Report writing, all this you know.